another impact of the drought we find ourselves in. Parts of California are now getting lower and lower. New research that's out today shows parts of California's Central Valley are sinking.
It's not a new problem, but scientists are now saying it's speeding up. KCRA3's David Bienick is here now to explain why parts of our state are sinking and the damage that's causing. David?
Well, Edie, this photograph shows how Central Valley, at least one spot, dropped from 1925 to 1977, some 28 feet. The report out today shows that these same areas are, in fact, still sinking. In fact, they've never been sinking faster.
Water now laps at the bottom of this bridge over a canal near Fresno, not because of any flooding, but rather because the land holding up the bridge is sinking, or as scientists say, subsiding.
Subsidence is a long-term problem that's really kind of insidious.
Today, state officials released a new report from NASA, which used planes and satellites to measure how far and how fast the ground is sinking, especially in four areas: near Arbuckle in Colusa County, near Yolo in Yolo County, near El Nido in Merced County, and near Corcoran in Kings County.
And there are areas that we've observed that are dropping around a foot a year.
The sinking bridge near Fresno and cracks in the concrete lining of the California Aqueduct are just a couple examples of the millions of dollars of damage already done. Officials blame the sinking on the drought and increased groundwater pumping by farmers and others. As the groundwater comes out, the layers of dirt collapse and become more compact.
This is a problem that's been around.
Last year, Governor Brown and lawmakers passed a law to regulate groundwater pumping, but it won't be fully implemented until the year 2040. Environmental activists like Jennifer Clary say today's report shows some parts of California can't wait that long.
And I think what's happening now is some people are going to implement it faster. So where you see problems, they're going to implement it more quickly.
In fact, Merced County and Glenn County in the northern part of the state have recently passed new groundwater regulations. And state officials announced today they will soon offer $10 million to help other counties with stressed groundwater supplies to come up with and strengthen their conservation plans.
So the drought has made everything kind of drop down. If the drought ends, will it go back up?
Yeah, but only slightly. When the rains come again, yeah, there will be a slight rebound effect. But mostly once the damage is done, it's permanent.
And then you wonder about the storage capacity for all that groundwater.
It's reduced.
Yeah. All right, David, thank you.